Now, over in Taiwan, one person was killed while more than 300 more were injured due to Typhoon Koinu. The storm swept through the southern tip of Taiwan Thursday, bringing torrential rains and strong winds. Thousands are still without power. Koinu, a Category 4 typhoon, made landfall in Taiwan's Kaohsiung Peninsula early Thursday morning. It's forecast to weaken as it heads towards the Chinese province of Guangdong. Now, in China, authorities in coastal provinces are on high alert as they brace for the typhoon. Some ferry services in Fujian have also been suspended. Let's get an update on weather now from Pagasa forecaster Rhea Torres. Morning, Rhea, go ahead.
Good morning to everyone. As of the moment, tropical cyclone Jenny continues to move further away from the Philippine landmass and is no longer directly affecting any parts of the country. Therefore, we currently do not have any tropical cyclone wind signal in effect over any parts of the country, and we also have no longer have any gale warnings raised over the seaboards of our country. So, although at the moment, the southwest monsoon or the enhanced southwest monsoon continues to affect the parts or some parts of Luzon area, particularly the western sections of our country. Over Ilocos region, Metro Manila, Zambales, Bataan, as well as Cavite, Batangas, and Occidental Mindoro, as well as Batanes and Babuyan Islands, we're expecting cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms due to the effects of the trough of the tropical cyclone Jenny as well as the southwest monsoon. For the rest of the country, generally fair weather conditions may be expected, although there are still chances of isolated rain showers or thunderstorms. And over this coming weekend, we're expecting tropical cyclone Jenny to move further away from the country and also the southwest monsoon to weaken. So we're expecting improving weather conditions over large portions of the Philippines over the next few days. And that is the latest here for Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
All right, thanks for that update, Rhea. The Philippine Coast Guard seeking cooperation from foreign authorities possibly involved in the boat ramming incident that killed three Filipino fishermen. The PCG says it has written to the government of Marshall Islands where the oil tanker suspected to have collided with a fishing vessel is registered. It's also getting in touch with Singapore's port since the tanker is heading there, but Philippine authorities have yet to receive a response from them.
After kung magka-receive tayo ng information sa kanila, doon natin sila bubuin natin dito sa conduct natin ng investigation. Nung nabuo na natin, we will submit it to the Department of Foreign Affairs.
The investigation is still ongoing, but the PCG believes it was just an accident. Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualdez vows to reinforce the country's facilities on Pag-asa Island. He visited the area shortly after Chinese ships again harassed a Philippine resupply mission to another outpost in the West Philippine Sea. Bianca Dava reports.
House Speaker Martin Romualdez visited Pag-asa Island on Thursday to see for himself various government projects on the island. He was accompanied by Armed Forces Chief of Staff General Romeo Bronner Jr. and Western Command Commander Vice Admiral Alberto Carlos. He also met with local officials to discuss the construction of other facilities on the island.
Kung anong pwede natin gawin dito, all of our government approach to support not just the Pag-asa, but all of our facilities, not in the Kalayan Island Group, but in the totality of the area. So we're looking at hindi lang to support, hindi lang yung budget ng DND, hindi lang DOTR, baka pwede rin yung DOT kasi napakaganda dito at pwede ito magiging isang tourist destination. Of course, we want to help the local governments through the DPWH funded projects.
These include the possible extension of the island's runway, expanding the docking facilities, and deepening the entrance of the sheltered port. China has maintained the presence of its Coast Guard and militia vessels in the West Philippine Sea, harassing Filipino fishermen and Philippine Coast Guard vessels. On Wednesday, Chinese vessels again tried but failed to prevent the latest Philippine resupply mission to its Navy outpost in Ayungin Shoal.
I would like to strengthen yung naging press statement ni ADG Jonathan Malaya, which he released last night, no? From the National Security Council, reporting to the public that we have already conducted a very successful resupply operation despite of the harassment, interference ng Chinese Coast Guard dito sa resupply operation. However, the Philippine Coast Guard will be releasing no yung detalye nitong nangyari sa resupply operation.
Coast Guard spokesperson Rear Admiral Armand Balilo says they are in dire need of additional ships and advanced technology in patrolling the West Philippine Sea. He also underscored the importance of intelligence funds in collecting information and surveillance activities.
Gumaganap kami sa isang maritime security operation, law enforcement activities, hindi lamang sa West Philippine Sea. Napakarami nating sinabi ko nga kayo na dapat bantayan. Kailangan natin yung intel funds to upgrade our system, yung human intelligence natin, ma-improve natin. Yung ating mga gadgets, yung mga technology, kailangan natin ma-improve para ma-improve natin yung ating surveillance, yung mga measures natin sa pagmamanman at sa pagko-collect ng information.
Bronner commends the determination of the resupply team despite Chinese aggression in the region.
Even if we say that we had a successful resupply mission, tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung pagharang ng mga Chinese Coast Guard at ng Chinese militia dun sa ating mga Coast Guard especially, no? Nakalusot yung maliliit na boats natin, yung resupply boats, but yung Coast Guard ay talagang hinarangan nila.
China, meanwhile, condemned the resupply mission, saying the vessels had entered its waters in the Spratly Islands without permission. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News, Pag-asa Island, Palawan.
House Speaker Martin Romualdez denying politics is involved in the realignment of confidential funds of Vice President Sara Duterte. In a rare press conference Thursday, Romualdez said such observations are mere speculation. See, some analysts earlier said the realignment of secret funds under the office of the Vice President and the Department of Education could be a strategic play by Romualdez ahead of the 2028 elections. But he says there's no truth to it.
People are reading too much into it. No, I think it's very, very straightforward and simple. No, so the CIF had the topic. It all came up. No, and there were a lot of discussions and debates in the House. No, so borrowing the words of the Vice President, that even she says that she could live without it, and she would leave it to the sound discretion of the Congress for its proper disposition. Under the circumstances, we felt that it would best be realigned to the agencies and to the departments and into the areas where we have just mentioned that are a priority.
Romualdez also agrees with Duterte. Confidential and intelligence funds must be used to ensure peace and security. But he says such funds should be given to agencies with that mandate.
With respect to the confidential funds, we are all for the confidential funds, and we are all for peace, no, and security, no. We are all for that. So yes, we are one. We are one with the Vice President in having to make sure that confidential and intelligence funds, you know, are always part of the equation, and of course, best left with the agencies and departments, no, that are most and best suited.
Duterte earlier slammed critics of her confidential funds, branding them as enemies of the state. Opposition lawmakers pushing back against Vice President Sara Duterte's remarks on critics of her secret funds. Albay Representative Edsel Agman says the Secretary of Education, the concurrent position of Duterte, must be reminded that schools are temples of knowledge and not arenas of surveillance. Now, for Ag Teachers Pointless Representative Francis Castro, Duterte's attacks did not work, making her resort to brand her critics as enemies of the state. She also calls the Vice President's comments, who resell red tagging and gaslighting. The Philippine Agriculture Department asks senators to let it keep its proposed confidential funds for next year. Assistant Agriculture Secretary James Layud says the 50 million peso allocation will strengthen operations against illegal traders and smugglers. Layug made the appeal after Senator Rafi Tulfo insisted on reallocating the department's confidential funds to law enforcement agencies.
So may mga quarantine na powers po ang mga FSRA natin, Food Safety Regulation Agencies like BAI, BPI, and PFAR, and also NMIS na will also need sana some support para naman mapatibay natin yung mga surveillance operation and ma-reinforce po itong mga accomplishment na nasimulan na rin ng DA po.
The Philippine Interior Department not opposing secret funds of local governments as long as these are within the bounds of law. Undersecretary Margarita Gutierrez says LGUs need to justify where the funds will go and that it should be fair with budget allotted for basic services.
LGUs po, may certain na pangangailangan po. Like naisip na intindihan po namin with regard to peace and order, security. So may mga ibang bagay po na yun po, sakop nun ng confidential funds. We go back to the basics. It should be in accordance to law. Dapat may proper accounting yan. And dapat commensurate yung gastos mo sa need talaga ng taong bayan.
Confidential funds of LGUs were put under scrutiny after Vice President Sara Duterte once again drew flak from critics. Data from the Audit Commission showed over 2 billion pesos of confidential funds were used by Duterte during her term as mayor of Davao City from 2016 to 2022. A police officer relieved from his post after claiming in a viral video a part of Commonwealth Avenue was blocked to let the convoy of Vice President Sara Duterte pass through. In a statement, the Quezon City Police District apologized for the incident. The QCPD said the officer mistakenly heard the word Vice President. He then cleared the traffic after assuming Duterte would pass through the area. But Duterte had no engagement there.